Hello everyone. Happy Monday. What a wonderful day. I've got my coffee here and I am ready to paint today. I found the most wonderful kind of music and it is called jazz music. And I thought, what a wonderful way to drink coffee and maybe do some painting. You caught me on a good day because today is the day we are going to attempt to paint a horse. I've had so many fans write to me and say, Jean, we love your work so very much, but we are really excited to see what sorts of wildlife you can paint. And I've always had a passion for horses. I've seen a horse just about 3 times, and each time has not been a very pleasant experience. The first time I was kicked, the second time I was kicked, and the third time I was nosed. So you never know what's going to happen with a horse, which is what is so much fun about horses, but they are magical creatures, and I think it's about time we get started. So I hope you have your coffee. I'm gonna take a quick sip, and I am ready to paint. Oh, that is just terrific. So now, I have my canvas here, and I've gone with a horizontal canvas so that we can get the full length of the horse. And I thought today, a fun little idea would be to outline our horse with my ballpoint pen. It's something you can find in your house, I'm sure, or at your local bank. Lots of ballpoint pens hanging around. Okay, so we're gonna get started with our magical creature. Now, I think my horse is going to be on a hillside. So, I've never actually attempted a horse before, so we'll see how this turns out, but I think I remember what they look like, even though I was mostly unconscious when I was around them. All right, so we're going to start with the head. Now, from what I remember, a head of a horse is round, and then we have a nice long horsey nose. There's my horse. We're getting started with the horse, and then it goes all the way up. So we've already started drawing out the horse, and I'm just using very simple a ballpoint pen. And let's get that neck. We have so many fun materials to play with today that I'm very excited to share with you. So I'm just drawing the outline of the horse. Now, those of you drawing at home, I invite you to draw whatever kind of animal you want. Now you'll remember we did one time draw a seahorse, which is simply a horse that lives underwater. This is in fact a land horse though. So we're just kind of outlining our horse. Now, one thing we must try to get right is our what's called hooves. And I learned that because that was what hit me in the face. So we've got a big old rump on the horse. And then, oh, let's draw some legs. I believe the legs go just down like this. And then this leg will go a little bit longer. There we go. And there's our horse. Now let's draw those hooves. Wonderful. And now horses, for those of you who don't know, have very skinny legs. So I'm just kind of capturing that. And they're rather short legs because the horses that I saw were in fact of the miniature kind. So we're gonna make sure those legs are very, very short. There's our other hoof. Here we go. We're just drawing up. There we go. And all the way up, and there's the first little bit of our horse. And let's draw his little belly there. There we go. There's a belly. Now, horses do have, in fact, 4 legs. So we're going to make sure that we draw all 4 legs. Although if you wanna just draw 1, that is completely up to you. Completely up to you. So now I am just drawing the other leg on the other side here. And as we've talked about before, depth. So now I'm just kind of getting that basic shape of the leg there. It's a little bit smaller than the first one, but that's okay. I don't think our horse minds. And then here's this back leg here. And we're just gonna finish up, and this is the basic outline of our horse. Just a nice big old body and some nice little short legs. Fantastic. So all that took was a little bit of ballpoint pen. Now we're going to take a marker and we're going to go over that with my lovely marker here. And all I'm going to do is just retrace it. Just retrace it so that we get a little color because horses are not in fact the colors of ballpoint pens. Here we go. Some are black, but not always. So I'm just gonna draw this one. My horse is gonna be, in fact, brown. And I'm just going over with the marker just exactly what I just drew. There we go. And we're just going all the way around. Now, sometimes you can see horses in the wild from what I've read. So if you're ever out just in nature, in the wild, look around and see if you can find just a wild horse somewhere in the jungle, or maybe, I don't know, in the woods. Who knows where horses live? There we go, and we're simply just outlining and tracing what we've already done. Very simple, because we do want to get some color. So here's our horse, and I'm just drawing the other leg, because remember, horses do have four legs, which I was not totally aware of until I did a little research. There we go. Now, if you ever see a horse underwater, they don't have legs at all. They have little arms, just like that. Here we go. Those of you joining, welcome. Today is, in fact, Horse Monday. We're listening to a new kind of music, and this is called jazz. Very wonderful jazz music. So we've started the outline of our horse, which I think looks just magnificent. We've got the whole body, and then we've got the legs. So I'm gonna let that sit for a moment, and let's go ahead and draw. And I'm using primarily marker today. Marker today because marker is just a great way to sort of outline some things. And then we'll go back and paint. This was a little bit less abstract than some of our other paintings. So now this horse, I think, is just on like a little bluff. So we're gonna draw a bluff. Just gonna outline it with marker. There's the bluff, and it's just gonna go right underneath here. And look at that. Now remember, you never wanna draw straight through the horse, because you wanna make sure you have what your object is standing on. So we're just drawing this little bluff, and I imagine this horse is maybe just doing a little bit of grazing. Now one thing I imagine is that maybe there are some hills in the background. Let's explore that. So what if there's a hill back here? Look at that. And that's just gonna come all the way down. There's one hill, and then maybe another one back here somewhere. How about there? Look at that. And now we simply have a horse in nature. It's so easy to do. It is so easy to do. Okay, so now I'm gonna jump back to my horse. And as you all know, I love paints, but special treat today, I've added extra paints to my palette. So we have some wonderful jewel tones. And I imagine my horse, I'm going to make maybe some fun little collar or some kind of magical hair color on my horse. Who knows? It is completely up to you. But to start, we are just going to make our horse a color. So I've picked this brown color, and then there is this little pastel color that we used back a while ago. Now pastels are just very light colors. So I'm mixing that brown with that pastel, and we're gonna just start to fill in the horse. And I'm wetting my brush. I'm starting out with my little brush. I think the big brush would overwhelm the horse. And we don't wanna overwhelm the horse, because I learned that when you do that, the horse will retaliate and simply kick you in the face. It's very unpleasant, but it's also a good lesson in horses. So I'm just wetting my brush, and I've got this beautiful brown and then also this sort of blonde pastel color. And that's what we're making our horse today. I've never drawn a horse before. I did a little bit of practicing for just about, 5 or 6 hours over the weekend, but never actually painted one. I was just practicing the outline. And I find the hardest thing to get with a horse is the rear end. The rear end is the hardest part to get really into on a horse. So you have to practice that very round shape. It's very challenging, but you all can try whatever works for you. I have found just a very steady wrist will really help you get right into that horse's rear end. Nice round shape. Okay, so now we've got this brown, we've got the blonde, and I'm just filling in my horse. We will work on the facial features a little bit later, but we're just filling in. Such a magical creature. I'm just being very, very careful here with my horse as far as filling in the color. Look at that. So I'm using my little brush. And we've drawn out, for those of you joining us, we've drawn out that our horse is somewhere in nature. Now, one other place I know you can find a horse is on a farm. And we did draw a farm just about a week and a half ago. Such a magical form. Here we go, and I'm getting that rear end. As I say, it's all in the wrist to really get into that horse's rear end. Just nice and round, and now we can finish it. We can fill in that rear end. Fill it right up with paint. Here we go, and I'm using, again, this wonderful blonde color. This horse is just gorgeous, coming alive so beautifully. Horses make for a great subject for art. You can put a horse, on a canvas, perhaps on a tapestry, and often on a t-shirt, which is where I've seen most of my horses, was on my sister Joni's t-shirts. I have lots of horses all the time. So we're just filling this in. You have to be careful when you're not drawing just nature. You have to be a little bit more careful, which you all have, I'm sure, experienced on painting at home here. We often do a lot of nature scenes, and a lot of them end up being very abstract because nature is just all in the eye of the beholder, I believe. That's wonderful. So we're just filling in the rest of my horse. Just filling that horse right up with paint. And I'm being very careful because we have to be a little bit more particular when we paint specific creatures. I hope all of you had just a wonderful, wonderful weekend. I'm getting into the springtime, which is a very, very great time to go out and look for horses. Now, some people I've heard have even gone so far as to ride a horse. Did you know you can ride a horse? So we're just finishing up here. Now, I've never tried it because, as I said, horses and I don't particularly get along, but I find them beautiful nonetheless. Just finishing up and filling in a little bit of color here, everyone. Look at that. Here's our horse. And then we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit dazzling with the horse, I think. We'll make that horse very fancy. Great, so now there we go. We've got that. And there's the base of our horse. Look at how that turned out just beautifully. Now, one thing I'm going to do, I'm going to wet my brush, give a little tap. Wonderful. And now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my marker again, just very simple brown, and we're just going to draw ears on the horse because horses do, in fact, have ears. There's one, and there's another. So make sure the ears are not too wide. There we go. Now what we're going to do though, is we're going to draw hair. So I'm gonna take another marker, a little bit darker, and we're gonna draw a little bit of a mane on this horse. Actually, I've decided what I might do is a beautiful brush stroke. Let's change gears here a little bit. And that's okay, you might have an idea and then decide, you know what, I'm gonna change gears. So first things first, let's fill in our horse's ears. So I've got a beautiful brown and it's very simple. I'm just gonna fill those guys in. Those little bad boys in. There we go. Now, because hair is a very, very brushed stroke, and as you know, I do love a good stroke, so we're going to stroke the horse's head, and I'm thinking we're going to do kind of a fun color. So I'm going to take a little bit of purple, because why not? Some creatures do have purple hair. My Aunt Edna always had purple hair. So now we're gonna do purple and a little bit of this gray, and I'm gonna have a little fun with this. Let's go with a little bit of this dark color too, because we wanna make sure we can see it. So we've got this bright purple, and we're just gonna go to town on this horse. Here we go, look at that. So there's his hair. And we're just gonna draw that mane all the way down. Let's get a little bit deeper color in here, and how about a little sparkle? Horses do sparkle. Here we go. And I'm just drawing this horse's mane. And mane, for those of you who don't know, is what we call the hair on a horse. And our horse today has some purplish hair. And I'm just using also a little bit of a darker color so that we can really capture that hair on the horse. Look at that. It's gonna go all the way down. It's just beautiful. Beautiful horse. Let's get a little bit more of that purple and just go right to town on that horse. There we go. Look at that. This is just magic. It's just magic. It's a very simple stroke, everyone. It's just this. It's just this. We've done this many, many times. Right. You pick your favorite. So I think that hair is done. Now, let's go ahead and draw. How about some eyes on our horse? So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of my brush. And now I'm going to jump into that darker color. And let's get a little eye going. Now, horses have just very beady eyes. So I'm just going to draw a dot. Little dot here. There we go. And then they also have these nostrils. So I'm just going to draw another dot. There we go. Just a dot here. Look at that. Just the details. Now one thing also that horses have, so I'm going to jump on back to that purple, is a tail. Let's give our horse a purple tail, and I think I'm going to add a little bit of blue to his tail because creatures can also have a little bit of blue. And we're going to use also this darker color, and we're just going to make the most majestic tail. There it is. And look at that sweep that we get. It's just a rotation of the wrist. And you can go back and forth however you want to draw that tail. Look at that. It's so easy to do. Anyone can do it, and we're just going to give the tail a little bit of movement. Look at that. Movement. Make sure that tail does connect to the rear end. Look at that. So we'll just color that in. There's that tail. It's beautiful. Just right on the rump there. So we've got a little purple and we've got a little bit of that blue. That's great. I'm just going to go back and fill in that purple and see if we can get a little bit more of that movement of hair. And we did. We sure did. We've got the eyes, we've got the nose. We are doing so well with our horse. Now the next thing I'm going to draw is what is called a saddle. Now if you were to ride a horse, which you'd be very lucky if you could, they're very hard to ride, is you would put on a saddle. Now a saddle just goes right on the back here, right on the back. So what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to make my saddle, oh, let's pick a fun color for this one. How's about this very dark, beautiful raspberry color with a little bit of sparkle. Now I'm making my brush very, 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 very wet because you need to be wet to ride the saddle with your brush. So we're going to draw what's called like a little blanket. And there's our blanket first. That's great. So you want to put a blanket on your horse with the saddle so the horse stays nice and comfortable. Because if the horse is not comfortable, that is when they will start to buck you off their back. I think that's what happened to me. I am not very clear because I wasn't conscious for very, very long. So we're just drawing that little blanket. Oh, it's such a rich raspberry color. And what I love about these rich colors is that they do end up drying with a little bit of glitter. It's just such a wonderful quality in these wonderful paints. Quality paints. There we go. So there's our blanket on the back of the horse. Now the saddle, for those of you who don't know, a saddle is typically made of what is called leather. And leather is made of cows. So I'm going to explore a black saddle with a little bit of brown because it's usually a very deep leather. And it just sits right on top. Right on top. And there's a little bit of a doodad in the front and the back so that you don't fall off. And there's our saddle. And then it's got these things called stirrups, which you can find at the doctor's office. So I'm going to draw those stirrups very lightly. There we go. And there's our saddle. Very simple. Very simple saddle. And there we have our horse. Great. Now, another thing that horses tend to have is they tend to have to be strapped to the saddle. So actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of this marker just to indicate the straps. So the straps come all the way up and almost over the eyes, just about. That's wonderful. And then they come all the way down and then across the nose. Here we go. And now this is going to connect, look at this, all the way to the back. Now I want to make sure we outline that with a little bit of paint. So I'm going to take my brush again. It's very complex, the horse, and I invite you to explore your materials. Exploration. There we go. So this goes all the way back. and there's our horse ready for riding, and there's a little loop there. Look at that, ready for riding. You can ride that horse all day long. There's our horse, look at that. One other thing I'm gonna add, horses do wear shoes. So we're gonna put little shoes on them. I'm gonna make these a little bit like dress shoes because maybe our horse is kind of fancy. Why not? Kind of fancy. Maybe a nice brogue. Love the word brogue. Say it like that. Who knows? Little shoes on our horse. Clickety clack. Look at that. Look at that. And then on the back feet too. Just little dress shoes. Why not? Make sure I'm that. And I'm using a very simple black for this, everybody. Just a very simple black. Maybe draw some heels on your horse. Who knows? Who knows? And there's our horse, everybody. So exciting. Let's go ahead and start to fill in that background. Very simple today. We're going to pull out the big guns. Pull out the big guns. So I've got my big old Jimmy here. And we've just got a very simple hillside in the background. We've done this many times and we're going to do it again. So I've got some green, but I've also got these wonderful what's called jewel tones. And because our horse is so fancy, we're going to put our horsey sort of in some jewel tones. So very simple. I'm just going to start to draw. Oh, this jewel tone is magnificent, everybody. So exciting when you explore new and different colors. New and different colors. So we've got this green, but then jumping onto those jewel tones. And then I'm just throwing in, everybody, a little bit of brown. There we go. Magical horse, magical land. Look at that. Look at that. It's so much fun when you try new and exciting creatures. A horse is such a majestic type animal. And they make the most interesting sounds. Kind of a nee. Kind of sound. It's so interesting what they do. There we go. And then they trot along, sometimes carrying people on their backs. Now, as I said before, we're just filling in a very simple hillside. And I'm using this wonderful variation of green. I have these beautiful jewel tones today, too. And then just a little bit of brown. And we're just going to do a broad stroke, everybody. You know how much I love a big old broad stroke. Here we go. Now, I think this horse looks to me like a female horse. I'm not seeing any male parts. I will just say that this is a lady horse. But you can make a male horse if you want to. It's really not too difficult. Completely up to you. So now I am just very, very carefully going over this hillside. It's just coming along so beautifully. So, so beautifully. I'm thinking we'll probably have to add a tree or two. Just a tree or two. Here we go. And I'm finishing up, everyone, with my hillside, and I'm using this magnificent sort of palette of jewel tones, which is just a very beautiful, almost glowing type of paint. It really says something about the quality of the paint when it has a little bit of jewel tones. There we go. We're just finishing up our hillside. That's one hillside that's just gorgeous, just gorgeous. Now, I do have some back hillside as well. So why don't we just quickly get into that. I'm just dabbing my brush here, dabbing and dabbing, and I'm gonna make this a little bit darker because we want to get depth. So I've got a little bit of brown, a little bit of black, and a little bit of that green now. And we're just gonna go all the way to the back here. That's wonderful. Very saturated brush, just saturated with paint, nice and moist. Let's make sure not to make our horse green. Although, if you want to make your horse green, I'm sure there are green horses somewhere. Probably in Ireland. Who knows? Okay, so now I've just made this a little bit darker to show a little bit of depth. A little bit of depth. There we go. And I'm wetting my brush, and we're just going to stay on that path. And then, of course, we'll add a little bit of sky. Look at that. And again, this is a little bit darker color back here. Just a little bit. There we go. I'm going to draw between the horse's legs. Make sure you get between the horse's legs. Here we go. Always want to get between the horse's legs so that you don't have any missing space. Here we go. It's just a light sort of color. And then we come all the way around the backside. And again, the backside of the horse I have found is the most difficult to sort of penetrate with that paint. and also that technique. So you really have to be careful with the backside of a horse. Here we go. And we're just finishing off. So beautiful. We've got one or two trees to add very quick. It's such a quick painting, this one. There we go. I'm just getting that back hillside. There we go. Now we've got our beautiful horse has, oopsie, this coloring. There we go. So we've got our horsey now. Lives in the hills. So beautiful. And let's do a quick sky, everybody, because what the hey. Let's keep Big Jimmy around for as long as we can. So I'm gonna do a little bit of blue, but then also a little bit of white. And we have this most wonderful jewel blue, just wonderful blue. And we're just gonna go ahead and paint our sky. So simple. It's just gonna be a very, very, very light sky today because I think this is a very bright day for this horse. I think this horse is very happy just being out side in the fresh air. Look at that. Look at that. Coming across. It's such a broad stroke, and I love painting this way because I find it very relaxing. Very relaxing indeed. This is the kind you can just move with your body. Look at that. I just let the music move my strokes. Just a nice dance here. Maybe look away for a minute. Maybe try this way. I don't know. You pick. Whatever strokes work for you, those are the strokes I want you to play with on your own. Here we go. So we're just finishing up our sky. Just finishing up here. There we go. Such a beautiful, beautiful horse. Here we go. Oh, and there's our sky. There we have it. Beautiful is that? Just wonderful. We've got one final thing to do, everybody, and that is, of course, drawing our trees, because I love drawing trees, and specifically trees that make it look like you're peeking out from behind, right? How wonderful is that? So I've got a nice little sort of black, but also a little bit of brown, and we're going to draw one tree here. There's one right there. Look at that. There we go. Let's draw a branch or two, and this one's coming out from behind. Tree is just kind of grabbing us right from behind, poking its way in the painting. That's beautiful. And how about a tree right by the horse? Maybe the horse is standing right underneath a tree, and who knows, maybe this is an apple tree. Here we go, drawing down. Just beautiful. This little hillside with a little tree. Make sure that tree's got plenty of girth. I do love girthy trees. That's wonderful. Just about finished here, everybody. I'm hoping you're having such a wonderful day. It is just a beautiful day here in my studio. I love sharing it with you. It is horse day. Just a very beautiful creature. We're just kind of getting the last little bit here of our trees. I've just got black, a little bit of brown, then I have this wonderful iridescent brown. We're just gonna stroke that right up the tree. Here we go. Here's our tree. And then finally, we've got one final task, everyone, and that is, of course, the leaves of our trees. So I've got wonderful greens, some iridescent greens. My brush is quite wet, so we're just gonna leave that be, and we're just gonna draw our tree. Here we go. Just our sort of a green guy right here. Love this green. What a rich, sort of royal green. Here we go. Just finishing up. Just a couple more little bits left. There we go. Getting some water in there. Okay. Make sure it doesn't get down too much. There we go. And make sure you use both sides of the brush. This is such an easy technique. We've done it many times. Just the edge of the brush there, the horizontal edge. Here we go. Let's get the other side as well. Little doodads over here. Maybe not quite as many. Maybe a little sparser tree. There we go. Look at that. Look at that. That's just gorgeous. And then to finish it off, I think we can add one final little touch, and that, of course, is our birds in the background. So quick. Because all it takes for birds, little birds, so easy, just a little bit of black. Get those birds right in the background. There's a nice bird. teams. And there's our birds. Maybe a couple over here. There it is. And there we have it, everybody. First attempt at a lovely horse just in the wild. Why don't we zoom in and have a little look here? It is Horse Monday. Beautiful horse, majestic creature. Some birds in the background, little hillside. And I did put little dress shoes, I said I call them brogues, right, on our horse. Who knows what he's doing out there today? Maybe grazing, maybe meeting some friends. Maybe he's looking for me to kick in the face. Who knows? Who knows? Zoom in on that hair. Just majestic. Someday I hope to successfully mount a horse and just go for a ride. Haven't been able to do that yet without getting seriously injured, but one day I really hope so. I really hope so, and I hope you have all had an opportunity to see a horse, to pet a horse, or to draw a horse. It's all up to you, and it is your imagination. You do whatever works for you. Thank you so much for joining us at Painting at Home. I am Jean Moss. Have a wonderful Monday.